Mapping Food Deserts in Southern California, Part 2. Downloading Data from the National Historic Geographic Information System. In the previous video, you learned how to set up your workspace. In this video, you will learn how to download data from the National Historic Geographic Information System. The National Historic Geographic Information System, or NHGIS, is a website that provides historical data and GIS files from the United States Census. The data is free to use, which makes this site an excellent resource. A link is provided in the written instructions. To access the data, you will first need to create an account. Click the login link. Then click the link to create an account. Fill out the registration information. When ready, click the submit button. Once you are registered, return to the login page and sign in. The NHGIS provides hundreds of unique datasets for years from 1790 through the present day. Datasets are aggregated at multiple geographic levels, including census blocks, census tracts, counties, and states. The vast number of data files can be overwhelming. To assist you with finding a particular dataset, the NHGIS uses a system of filters to help you narrow down your search. To start, use the first filter to determine the geographic level in which you are interested. Under Apply Filters, click on Geographic Levels. When the Geographic Levels options appear, click the plus sign next to County and Census Tract. This means that the NHGIS will only show you data that is available at the County and Census Tract level. When you are ready, click Submit. The next filter determines the date ranges for the data sets. Click on the Years filter. When the Years options appear, check the box next to 2016 under non-decennial years. When you are ready, click Submit. The topics options refine your search further by limiting the subject matter of the dataset. Click on the topics filter. When the topics options appear, scroll down until you can see the income category. Click the plus sign next to household and family income. When you're ready, click Submit. Next, click the datasets filter. Notice that with multiple filters active, the NHGIS dims unavailable datasets. Under 2016 American Community Survey, check the box next to 2012_2016_ACS5B 5-year data, 2012 through 2016, tracts and larger areas. When you are ready, click Submit. The results should appear on the page. Use the drop-down menu to select the number of results per page to show all of the results at once. This step makes it easier to find a specific dataset using the Find function on your browser. Under the source tables, locate the table named Poverty Status in the Past 12 Months of Families by Family Type, by Social Security Income, by Supplemental Social Security Income, and Cash Public Assistance Income. I recommend using the Find function on your browser to make it easier. When you find it, click the plus sign. When you click the plus sign, the data cart updates with the number of source tables checked. The GIS Files tab provides county and census tract shapefiles. Click on the GIS Files tab and add the county and census tract shapefiles to the data cart by clicking on the plus signs next to each. Now that you have the data tables and the county and census tract shapefiles added to your cart, you're ready to check out. On the data cart, click Continue. On the Options page, you should see a list of your source tables and GIS files. You should not need to change anything on the Options page. On the data cart, click Continue again. The Review page provides different data formatting options. A simple comma-delimited file is best for GIS. On the Review page, select the radio button next to comma delimited and combine different breakdown data types into a single data file. Leave all other options unchecked. Write a brief description so that you remember what you requested. When ready, click Submit. It typically takes about 5 minutes for the NHGIS to prepare your data. You will get an email when your data is ready. You can also refresh the NHGIS Extracts History webpage after about 5 minutes. The page will update with links to your data when ready. In a previous activity, you learned how to save files directly to your original folder. use the links under Download Table Data and Download GIS Data and save the files to your original folder. The shapefiles are very large and may take a few minutes to download. Once ready, click the 7-zip software to decompress the files. Delete the original compressed zip files when done. Removing them saves space and helps to prevent confusion later. The census tracts and county shapefiles are double compressed, meaning you will find a zip file within a zip file. It is a frequent source of confusion when working with NHGIS data. You need to decompress the contents of the shape subfolder. If you fail to do so, you will not be able to use the files in ArcMap. Open the shape subfolder and decompress the contents. The NHGIS uses a series of numbers and letters that are generated when you acquire the data. Unfortunately, these numbers are not very user-friendly. To prevent confusion, be sure to rename these files to human-friendly names such as county-level income and tract-level income. Using what you learned in the previous step, return to the NHGIS website and download total population data at the census tract level for year 2016. The source table is named Total Population. You will not need a GIS file because you already downloaded the census tract shapefile in the previous step. Save the source table to your original folder and decompress the file. Delete the original compressed file when done. Removing it saves space and helps to prevent confusion later. Give the CSV file a human-friendly name such as tract level population. In the next video, you will learn how to use the project tool.